Okay, are we live on Twitchison? Okay, we are now live on Twitchison. Good. So let's go here and do that. Guess I'll go and do it to one. That's fair enough. So let's just get started on the mining part. Because I need materials. And I didn't move my materials to storage, some materials above the storage. Good to harvest that later. But that's not important to the task at hand. It's one of the many things I need. There we go. materials is needed for major builds. That, and I'm almost completely out of granite. And right, if you ask me. For much roofing material this has become, I'm surprised I need a lot of it. If iron shows up in the middle of it, I'll take it. Same with redstone. Okay. There's zombie villagers running loose in here. Mining, so we can do a lot more projects. I don't care where you're at. doing that? Watching the updates, we get the big stuff. Oh god, my world is really one of those. Well, it's got all this digged under it. stop doing that. Okay, let's go back above. That. need to do something about this knitting information for. Stuff for. We need to make some type of experience farm. And I have an idea, we just need to go find it. Give me that before I be stupid. Okay, let's go find that once and for all. We have a different issue. I can't use. Can't use that one to do the work, unfortunately, because it's too low. Okay, I know what else I need to go get. You. This way. Thank you. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's do that for a second. Wrong one. Oh crap. Hate you things. Shit. Go away. Why? Any more? Thank you. Oh crap, what did I find again? Where you went, you little bastards? I hate silverfish. Oh, come on! Stupid thing. There, try that again. Okay, that helps to find that out. Put that in there. Oh, come on! Ethic Creeper! This makes no sense how I'm getting this crap. So let's finally fix this issue. Once and for all. Because I am so sick of this issue. F is the surface on this thing? Come on! Finally. Do. Okay, that's perfect. What did I do? Okay, I've got the mine with more amethyst. When it comes to that part, I would do a bit later, but right now we need to go to something more important. That part. You go to the ocean real quick. Oh. Hi, Cupron Axel. Seriously. What? Axelar is causing some trouble. I really don't know how many of these I'm gonna be needing. So if I can at least get 64, I should be good. Oops, one extra. Okay, got that. Now let's head back to this one. Go find the magma cubes. And of course, my soul cube, my soul sand. Two soul sand for sure. I'll just grab two of those. Now I have a reason to build a bridge over here. I found that one by pure accident. I'm gonna have to find a way to get into these mountains. Wait, what? Why am I having trouble with the mini map? Okay, this is ridiculous. I have to go out. See if this will straighten the damn map. No, it's not straightening the map. What the heck? But this thing's being a little shit. Oh well. I need two water buckets. Okay, let's see here. So. For some reason, my brain is not registering how to do this anymore. Which is bad when you ask me. tree farm. That's what I need to watch again. We did it again. Verizon has been named America's most reliable network by Root Metrics, and our customers rated us number one for network quality in America, according to J.D. Power, proving that there's only one for us. I don't care about the commercials. So I can see what's going on here.
Oi, how you doing? It's me, your boy Waddles. Welcome back to the Minecraft Guide, episode number 12. I'm Mike, and we're going to work on it today. What we're doing today is going to set us up big time for even more enchanted.
Tell me about it.
That's my bad. Now, last episode went really, really well. If you caught it, then you already know. Then we have a full set of diamond armor, not to flex or anything, but yeah, it looks good over here. Now, for now, I'm going to leave the diamond armor inside of the enchanted room. This armor stand. Why? Well, I think I'd like to save this diamond armor for netherite armor. That's right, we're gonna jump right from iron now to netherite. So that stuff is just gonna sit there for now until we get netherite, which honestly probably won't be too far off from now. We're also probably going to wait to enchant the rest of that stuff until it's netherite. Netherite has a higher enchantment value, which basically means we'll have a better chance to get better enchantments from the enchantment table if it's netherite. Also, if you saw the last episode, you know things went amazingly well, and not only in the diamond department. Last episode, we found three spawners. The important one, the one that we care about today, is the zombie spawner, the first spawner that we found. Today, we're going
tell
to
me about it.
Three, and let all of this turn into ice. It's gonna take a little while, but if we go Admittedly, all of that might seem pretty complicated if you're into this stuff, but really, trust me, it's not that bad. So, what we're doing today, we work for zombies and skeletons. We're covering zombies, you know, it's a little bit of a bummer, but it's gonna be fun. So first thing first, you're gonna wanna drop a flat on top of the spawn. Of course, when we're talking about moving mobs away from the thing, if there were to be a mob, I'd have been moving away.
Yeah. Okay. Let me just fix this ceiling, cause I don't really want. I don't care if this thing looks like it does. But the materials above it is gonna bug me. And since I live in this area, I kinda need it. Okay, I know one thing I need to do. I need finishes. And some coke. I will have to go into this mountain and just literally empty out all those things. And just so the spawner will work properly. But first I need to build the main thing first. I just need XP farm. One furnace. Oh yeah, the coal got moved. A lot of kitty cats making a lot of noise. Coal is now over here. I don't know if I'm going to be using all of that, but let's have it on the safe side. Just in case we need that. I've got one thing. I'll be right back. I have a spell crafting table, I should be using it. No, the fastest way for me is not to go up and down. Just TP to these places. I'm gonna have to move that later.
Alright, a little bit of digging later, no talking, and boom. We have a 9x9 room with the spawner dead center. Now let's talk about the
the hell? Okay. I need to work on this. He's no longer talking. My luck, I can't even figure this out. Wow. That was a bit unwanted. Now that's looking better again. Then I go over here, the different story. go to the home base real quick. I think I have some ladders somewhere, but I'm not sure where. If I don't, I can always make some. Ah, I knew it. I knew it has it somewhere. Sand we need. Grab a couple of stacks of these. I've no clue where I put those. Huh. Did I could have been stupid and did that. Let's check up here. Yes, that's exactly where they are. So let's go get some more amethyst, just because it's needed. just realized I need to move this over here. Technically raining. Thank you.
quick by making one water stream somewhere in this room to move zombies to one particular block, and then move a stand on the other side of that block to attract the zombies in that area, swing at them with my sword over and over again, and then the zombies would be taken out. It would work, but it would be really tedious, and my sword would probably take a lot of durability there. Basically, not good. So option number one, have to hit the zombies like a million times. Option number two, have to hit the zombies one time, and one time only for them to go away. That's going to save our sword a lot of durability and make the farm a whole lot more easier and enjoyable to use. We're definitely going with option number two. So to get the zombies that are going to spawn from this spawner down to a one-hit kill, we're going to need to take a lot of health away from them. How do we do that easily? Well, simple. Fall down. We can raise the zombies up really high, let them drop, let's take a bunch of damage, and we hit them once and boom, they're gone. They're existing. It's over. If we drop the zombies 22 blocks, or 23, they'll be brought down to a one-hit kill. If we drop them 24 blocks, they will die on impact. We don't want that. Now, I recommend going 22 blocks just to be safe. You never know. Maybe the zombie takes a little bit of damage somewhere along the line, somehow. To sort of account for that, 22 blocks. But if you're living on the edge, it's 23. The 22s are golden numbers. So, with that in mind, you need to pick a side to move the zombies to. Our room for grinding the zombies is going to be over in this general area, which means we want to move the zombies over there. If we want to move the zombies that way, we have to pick either this wall or this wall to transport them. I'm thinking, maybe, that we'll use, let's see, our base is over that way, so let's actually use this wall. What we're going to do is dig out the floor along this wall, one block wide, one block deep. This is going to be an additional water trench. You see, eventually, we'll put a bunch of water trenches back there, they'll all flow over here, then we'll have a water trench right here, flowing this way into a mob elevator. But, little problem, this is 9 blocks, water only flows 8. So, what do we do to get around that? Easy. Find the middle, dig down, then dig the other blocks down as well. So right here, this dirt, this can actually come out. Which means, we need to get back to the floor work. We need to beautify this area too. It all needs to look good. Yes, I'm gonna be like that, I'm sorry. I know, I'm being OCD about how my farm looks. Definitely. Needed to look beautiful. This is going to be the best looking mob spawner that you have ever seen. All of YouTube, Mumbo Jumbo, Ezo, Brian, yep, they have nothing on this, again, beautiful mob spawner. So anyways, we have our trench right here, one block wide, four blocks right there, dip down, five blocks right here, wall. Wall is a problem. We're going to need to cut into the wall a couple of blocks. By a couple, I mean literally a couple, or three blocks? Yeah, three blocks into the wall right there, and also three blocks high. Boom, just like that, that's going to be perfect. Now temporarily, we're going to put a dirt block right there, and we're going to dig this block out. Eventually, we'll be putting a block of ice right here, but for now, we're going to want to dig it out like I just did, and do that. Then, we're actually going to drop a water bucket in there. More on that in a few minutes. Now, the rest of this floor needs to be fixed. Whoops, sorry, I dropped water in the back. I'm sorry, Kate, the torches are going to go away. You know what? I got to fix it. Imagine that I have a mob elevator right here. It's going to raise the mobs up, then it's going to move them over in line this way. Maybe, I don't know, let's go one, two, three, maybe four blocks. It'll move four blocks over, and then drop it. Or three blocks. Let's go three blocks. I like three a little bit better. Three is a better number. So, this will move them up three blocks over, and then drop them all the way down into this room in here, where I just dumped the water. I want the mobs to land on, let's say, this block right here. This feels like a pretty good block. Now, that's the bottom of our mob spawner. I guarantee that the spawner will be active from down in this room. Have to double check. All we need to do is poke a small hole in the floor, and then we just basically move around. Is the spawner on? No, it's not. But if we move up one block right there, it is on. So that's golden. That's perfect. Which means that's going to work. Now our mobs, again, are going to fall onto this block right here. It honestly might not be active from all the way over here. So let's check this out. We're all the way over here. Is it going to be active? We're going to have to take out a little bit. Let's see. What do we have here? It is not active. And still not active. But active right here. Okay, that's good. And then if we move over, it's active here. Okay, so what we're going to do is actually move this over one more block. We're going to move the mobs over literally, I think it should be two blocks now. And then drop them. Then the spawner is active in even more areas. We're actually going to raise the floor of this cave up a couple blocks. Now today we're not really worried about the aesthetics of this farm at all, and that includes the driving room. So for now, we're just going to fill it in with cobblestone. Eventually, we can definitely come back in here and care about it a little bit more. So let's go maybe one block up, and then how are we feeling about this? Okay, scratch that. This is going to be the floor level. It doesn't look very
I need to. Okay, let me jump to home base real quick. Not because of the bed, but because to see if I have a trap door I can use. Let's go back to our cave here. Okay, I'm going to end it here. Don't leave. I'll be right back to restart this.